Inspired Planet Productions is located on the Bruce Peninsula in Ontario, Canada, right on the shores of the Great Lakes, where 20% of the world's fresh water comes from. AllTooClear is a documentary series about the invasion of the Great Lakes by the quagga mussel.
These little critters, quadrillions of them at the bottom of the Great Lakes, have completely changed how these ecosystems function. When we first started talking about doing a story about the offshore ecosystem of the Great Lakes, we realized this was a massive challenge. So how do you show people something that they almost never have any experience with personally? Unless they're divers, and even then, most of the area we're talking about is inaccessible to divers. We found that there were some consumer devices, which were okay, but their cameras were terrible. And there were a few remotely operated vehicles designed for big expeditions and scientists mainly. And so we found pretty quickly the Boxfish Luna as this sort of underwater drone concept.
The Boxfish Luna kind of fits in this pretty amazing niche where someone like an independent production company can get one and start exploring waterways and lakes and oceans in a way that before just really hasn't been possible. So it's a really exciting time for us as filmmakers.
What really stood out with the Boxfish Luna is that it had an incredible camera. So it is a real camera underwater, and it sends the signal up to the surface in real time, 4K, uncompressed, raw if you want. We can control all of the camera settings from the surface. We see exactly what we're filming, and we have total control, exactly the same as if you have the camera right in front of you. By putting the A7S III into the Luna, we're able to see in very, very low light conditions. More than 300 feet, almost 100 meters without any extra lights at all, which is pretty incredible.
The Boxfish Luna has an amazing battery life. So when we compare it to something that we can get with, say, divers who are limited in time to, say, 30, 40 minutes, with the Luna, we can be down for hours. And honestly, we usually run out of energy before the Luna.
One of the innovative things about the Luna is that you can point it in any direction and then move in that direction. So that's really opens up a whole lot of opportunity for filming both moving wildlife, like a fish, or if you want to get a really smooth pan of a lake bottom or a shipwreck or something, the sky's the limit in the freedom you have in order to get those shots as you want to get them.
One of the things that really drew us to the Luna was the safety aspect of it. We're not going to be sending divers down. We're not going to be asking them to go a little deeper, to stay down a little longer to get that shot. With the Luna, we're all safely above the surface, and we can see in real time what the Luna is seeing, what animals the Luna is interacting with. And that was something really special for us. The other thing is that the Luna doesn't emit bubbles. When we've encountered a lot of fish, they don't seem to be too concerned about us. In fact, some fish even come to us to check us out. The Luna allows us to find an animal underwater and just be with it while it explores the environment, which is really kind of a magical thing that we haven't really been able to do before. So for AllTooClear, we've been working with a lot of fish scientists who are pretty excited to see the material we're putting out there. Unfortunately, a lot of the research methods that fish scientists use are fatal for the fish. So the footage that we've been able to gather with the Boxfish Luna of fish, you know, doing their thing, exploring the environment, eating, reproducing, the scientific community has just been so excited because they're able to see the fish that they love and work with all the time alive and interacting with the environment. For us as wildlife filmmakers, it's amazing to get great film, but it kind of is a whole other level when the work you're doing is in collaboration with scientists who are then able to use that material to further the scientific research on a specific species and to hopefully, help that species if it's struggling.
being able to have this freedom to film underwater has completely changed how we think about what we're going to do with our work in the future. We can get in the middle of a school of fish and be right with them in a way that would be not possible, I don't believe, before this. The sky's the limit, really. We have a whole series of projects that we want to do to show people things they've never been able to see before using this technology, with an initial focus on freshwater, but marine ecosystems are in our future as well.